everybody. How are you today? It's Miss Karen here with my friend Jack.
The plumber.
Jack the plumber. We're here today and we're going to give another drawing lesson here at the Bethel Park Community Center. And we also brought a sculpture. We brought an owl sculpture. Our good friend George Nickel, he sculpted this snow owl. And he also lives here in Bethel Park. So he did a beautiful job on this owl, right, Jack?
Yes, he did. Sits on my dresser at home. I get to see it all the time.
Yeah. Have you ever seen an owl, Jack?
Yes, I have. I have one in my backyard.
Oh, wow. That's pretty awesome. Yeah. Okay, again, we're ready to start. And all you need is a pencil, any type of pencil, probably a pencil sharpener, and any type of paper will do. These are the basic steps to draw some fun animals. And we're outside today, right, Jack?
Yes, we're outside.
So we're outside. You can draw anywhere. You could draw outside. You could draw inside. You could draw in the car if you're going on a long car trip. And again, this is all you need and a piece of paper. I don't have the paper with me. But it's fun to keep your sketchbook with you or a little bit of paper and a pencil and a sharpener or a pen, whatever you want to draw with. And the point is you can draw anywhere. Okay, are we ready to start?
I'm ready.
Okay, do you want to read us some owl facts, Jack?
Yeah, we could start with a joke first.
A joke? Okay.
Why did the owl invite his friends over his house?
Why did the owl invite his friends over his house?
Owl by himself.
Oh, he didn't want to be owl by himself. I like that joke.
Owls have very big eyes and make a unique hoot-hoot sound. There are 200 species of owls and 19 species live in North America. Owls live in forests, deserts, mountains, and prairies. And I have an owl who lives in one of the trees in my yard. And we just discussed that.
Yeah, you do. I heard him. What kind of sound does he make?
You do it better than I do. They make a lot of sounds.
Okay.
Do a hoo, hoo, hoo sound. Hoo, hoo. And I can hear him late at night hooting and hooting. Owls are most active at night, which means they are nocturnal. Owls like to eat insects, small animals, and some like to eat fish. Female owls are usually larger than male owls by about 25%.
Wow.
Owls can almost turn their heads all the way around. They can turn their heads at about a 270-degree angle.
Oh, I wish I could do that. That would be a great stretch. Yeah. All right. Thanks, Jack, for those facts.
You got it.
Okay, so we are going to begin with this owl right here. Very simple. He or she is just sitting on a tree branch, like in your backyard, right?
Yeah.
And then we're going to move on to this one. This owl's up flapping. He's flying around. And then we got another owl right here who's sort of in the shape of George's sculpture, Snow Owl. And he got the moon behind him. Okay, so are we ready? All right. So to begin, we're going to start with a circle shape. It's not a perfect circle. And we're just going to go like this. And I put begin right there. And then we're going to get the owl's body. And we're just going to go like this and up. And that's our owl. Does it look like an owl yet, Jack?
Sure does.
No, it doesn't.
Looks like a little bit of a snowman.
Sort of, kind of like a snowman. Snow you're correct. Okay, so our owl needs some ears. Let's put some ears here. This one's a little bigger. Let me make that smaller. So our owl needs some ears, right? And how about our owl's toes? I'm just making an oval for the toes. I'm doing three right there. And now it's starting to look a little better, right?
Sure.
Okay, how about the wings? We need some wings for our owls. I'm gonna start right here and I'm just gonna go like that. That's it, pretty simple. And then I'm just gonna use my finger to erase, you would use your pencil, right, Jack? Your pencil eraser sure. to erase. And then I'm going to do it again on this side right here. I'm going to go down and bring it up. And if you don't want to go over, you don't have to go over this line, but I like to round them out a little bit. And I am going to erase right there. So now our owl has his or her wings. How about this tail right here? Let's give our owl this tail down here. We'll give a tree branch first. Tree branches are so much fun to make. And any type of tree branch will do. I'll give it some lines. How about that? So now our owl's tail is going to come down, and I'm just doing that. And now our owl has a tail. How about that? What do we need?
Nice so we could see.
Yeah, we need some eyes, right? Owls have big, gigantic eyes. I'm going to do big eyes right there. And how about the owl's nose? Let's move this one down. We'll make it a little darker so everybody can see. And then this is the shape right there of the owl's beak. And then you could put some more, some more circles in here. Any type of circles. They don't have to be perfect. And I'm going to give my owl some big eyeballs. Okay. And then now it's time for what? Some details. Let's give our owl some details. And I like to do this. And see, you don't have to worry about that line right there. Not being perfect because we don't want it to be perfect. So now it looks like the owl got some feathers. Right, Jack?
Yeah, you forgetting something over his eyes?
What?
No eyelashes today?
Oh, yeah, no eyelashes on this owl today. Maybe the next one, right? Okay, so we have our owl, very simple. Now we're just gonna use some drawing marks. Drawing marks are so much fun. So you could do lines like this for his wings, and then look at this. We're just gonna make waves. Like, remember when we were doing the dolphin, Jack, and we used some waves? Mm-hmm. And that's all I'm doing. I'm just going like this to give our owl some texture, okay? And you could also do something like this if you wanted. Just to give any type of details you want to your owl. Pretty simple, huh? We'll put one up here too. Okay, that's it for our owl, for this top owl. I do want to show everybody something else. Jack, would you want to erase today with your
magic
eraser? Okay, I want to show everybody this owl over here. Use your imagination. We started with a circle. Jack said it looked sort of like a snowman. So this one I colored with the highlighters. And I went crazy with my drawing marks. And I gave it all kinds of bold colors. And I even drew hearts and dots, hearts and circles on the owl, on his belly. And then instead of the moon, I put a big heart. So have fun with it. Use your imagination. But again, this is the basic steps for this owl. And then we'll put this one up here in case anybody wants to look at it. Okay, I need the board again. Jack the plumber, yeah, we're going to go and try to draw this owl right here. This owl is up in flight. He's flying around Jack's backyard. So right here I put begin, and then I put then I put then. How about that, Jack?
Right.
Okay, so we're gonna start with Oops, what happened here? Technical difficulties.
Your little magic.
My magic eraser
has no water on it.
Is very wet. Uh-oh. Okay, let's try this other marker. We'll try this one. I think it'll work if I use this one. Okay. Yep, it works. Okay, so I don't know. Sort of looks like a shield, maybe. What do you think that shape is? Yep. Maybe like some type of jewel, right? And then we're going to go up here and we're going to go like that. Okay, and that's how we're going to begin this owl in flight. And then I'm going to erase this. And it's still a little wet. A little bit of technical difficulties, but that's okay. We don't mind. We have an eraser, right? Okay, let's give our owl some ears right here. Okay, and let's give our owl, well, let's go right here first. Let's give right here, and we'll just go make our waves again. Uh-oh, go right here, and I'm gonna do that. All right, so now our owl needs some wings, right? So I am gonna start up here, and I'm gonna start right here. And I'm just going to bring my waves down diagonally. Like that. So what's our owl need?
Eyes.
Let's erase right here. And we'll give our owls some big eyes right here. One. Two. Put some eyeballs in here. And again, we're gonna go after the nose. Is you can make it as big or small as you want. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger on this one. And you can give as many circles as you want for your owl's eyes. And then I'm just gonna use the waves again. I'm gonna go like this and make some more waves. And do some more here and here and right here. They're so much fun to do. They're just waves. Okay, so now we have, whoops, our owl in flight. I'm gonna make his eyes a little darker. You can make his eyes however you want. And if you want to give your owl a smaller nose, that's fine too. Let's show everybody if we give our owl a smaller nose. Okay, and that's it. Pretty simple. We started with like a shield shape, and then we put this shape on top of it. And our owl's flying. Maybe he's flying up in your backyard.
He is.
Is he in your backyard from one of the trees? Okay. All right. We can take this down. And then I just want to show you one more owl. Oops. Just lost the easel. And look at this owl. So it looks like the snow owl that George made. So all you would do is start with a circle right here. And then just make that shape again. But bring the wing out. And maybe the moon is behind your owl. And this is the owl in Jack's yard. I'm not sure what he's sitting on. Maybe a long, long tree branch, because don't you have big trees in your yard,
yeah.
Jack? Okay. All right, that's it for our owls. We are doing forest animals today. So, Jack, what do you think's another forest animal?
We could think maybe a squirrel.
A squirrel? Have you ever seen a squirrel?
Yeah, a lot of them in my yard.
A lot of squirrels in your yard.
Lots and lots.
Okay. And what do squirrels like to eat?
Acorns.
Acorns.
Yes, they do.
Squirrels like to eat nuts.
Lots of nuts.
Do you like nuts?
I like cashews, peanuts, stuff that's not good for you. I like.
Oh, I think they're good for you. I think they're good. I like walnuts. Walnuts are really good for you. There's a walnut tree around where I live, and a lot of the squirrels get the walnuts. Do you want to tell us any facts?
You think I should start with a joke? What do you think?
Okay, we'll take a joke.
Why can't you be best friends with a squirrel?
Why can't you be best friends with a squirrel? Let me think.
Because he will drive you totally nuts.
Oh, he'll drive you totally nuts. We were just talking about that they like to eat nuts.
Okay, squirrels can live almost anywhere, and they usually do, except for Australia. There are about 200 species of squirrels. They also have flying squirrels. These squirrels have a flap of skin between their front and back legs so they can glide in the air between the tree branches.
I never saw a flying squirrel.
No, most tree-dwelling squirrels prefer to live alone. Squirrels love to eat nuts. Squirrels bury their nuts. They find, because their winter comes, it's hard to find food. So they go find their buried nuts to eat as their winter food.
Oh, wow.
They find the buried nuts with the greatest sense of smell and usually find about 80% of the nuts that they buried.
80%, huh?
Well, what happened to the 20%?
I don't know. Tell me.
Well, those nuts usually grow into oak trees, so they lose 20% of what
they
bear.
So 20%, that's a really interesting fact.
Yes, it is.
I like that. Okay, we need the board again. All right, I don't know how you're going to hold both, but I think if you hold that right there, that might work better. And our easel will not fall down. By the way, this is an easel. Very simple. You could use it for your drawing. You could use it for canvas if you're painting. Very lightweight. Okay. So this is a little different of a shape where I have begin. So I don't know. I would say maybe like, what if it looked like this shape? It was like an arrow going down, sort of, kind of, but I'm going to round it up. So what I was talking about was like an arrow pointing downwards, but we're going to round it out, round out the triangle. So let's take this, and I'll just use this to erase.
Paper towel.
How about that? Okay, and then we're gonna go. Can you maybe
you
hold
wanna slide that and I'll hold both of them there? Let's
do okay,
it like this.
That'll work.
We'll make it work. There we go.
There, now you got it. And then we're just gonna bring the squirrel's body down here. Okay, very simple. Begin right here, then we'll do this shape here. Now all we gotta do is give our squirrel some details. I'm gonna round this out. So that's where you would need your eraser. And I'm going to give my squirrel some ears right here, like that. Make this one a little bigger. Okay. And I'm going to put my squirrel's eyes right here. Okay. Not down here. I'm going to put them right here. And some eyeballs. And what else, Jack? Eyelashes.
Of course.
I like eyelashes.
What about whiskers? You like them too?
Yep. And now here's the squirrel's nose. Okay. I'm going to put it way down here. All it is a rounded upside down triangle. And I'm going to give my squirrel a smile, of course. Then I'm going to use these. These are drawing lines. I'm going to go like this. It gives us the sense that the squirrel's nose is coming out. Okay, and did you say whiskers?
Yeah, it looks
good. All right, how about some whiskers?
Yep.
All right, we got it. Okay, so now, what does our squirrel need?
Arms.
Arms and legs, right?
Yeah.
So our squirrel is sort of looking at us, but sort of turned to the side. So this is pretty simple for the leg. We're just going to make like a circle here. And go out like that. And then we're going to make the squirrel's toes like this. And then I'm going to take it up to there just to make it look a little bit more proportioned. And then I'm going to erase right here and erase this line right here. It isn't working too good. And then I'm going to do right here, see this? That's the squirrel's other leg that we don't really see. So I just did a little teeny piece of a circle, and I'm going to bring his toes out. You can make any type of toes you want. Okay. And how about a tail? Let's do the tail before we do the arms. I started my tail way up here. I'm going to put an X mark where I started the tail. And I just went out. And how fun is this, Jack, to do that? And then I'm going to start here and go like this. How fun is that? Mm-hmm. To make a squirrel's tail. All right. So now our squirrel is holding an acorn. So we're going to draw the acorn first. And let me show you here. So I'm just going to go like this. That's a rectangle. And I'm going to bring it down like that. Okay. And then I'm going to do a little round top here. And go like that. And I'm going to put some X marks on the acorn. So we're going to draw this right here. And the squirrel's going to be holding it. So here's our rectangle. Here's that shape. And there's the stem of the acorn. Did you ever eat acorns, Jack?
No.
No?
Let's say I did.
I think I might have. Okay, so now we need the squirrel has to hold the acorn. Let's bring the arm down. I'm just going to give him three. You know what I need, Jack? I think I need this. This will help me.
Yeah.
Right here, my eraser for the wipe off board. That'll help a lot. Okay, so I'm just going to give him three fingers. You could give him as many fingers as you want. And then, of course, we need another arm coming over. So I am just going to take from here and go one, two, three, like that. And I'm going to erase right here. Is that the bell? Sorry.
5 minutes. Yeah.
Oh, boy. Okay. And there we have our squirrel. So our squirrel could be on the ground, in a tree, wherever you want. And you could give some more texture like this. Okay. There's our bells. All right. And there's our squirrel. Okay. We got one more super cute forest animal to show you, an owl erase. And Jack, I think you should read some facts about this one. What could it be? Do we have another joke?
We're going to need that too. A joke.
Do we have a joke?
Let's see. Yeah, I think we do.
Okay.
Did you hear the joke about the skunk, Karen? Did you hear it?
The joke about the skunk. No, I did not.
Good, because the joke stinks.
Oh, good one, Jack. The joke stinks.
Skunks live in forests, woodlands, grasslands, and deserts. Skunks have an excellent sense of smell, but they have very poor eyesight and can't see anything over 10 feet. Skunks like to eat plants, insects, small animals like frogs, but they really like to eat people's garbage.
Garbage?
Oh, yeah.
Did you ever see a skunk?
I've seen them in a garage before.
Oh, wow.
Parking garage, that is.
Oh, boy.
Skunks are known for their superpower, hard to get rid of, horrible smelling spray.
I bet.
Horrible smelling spray can travel up to 10 feet. The terrible smell really does not cause any damage, but if you ever get sprayed by a skunk, this horrible, disgusting smell can linger on for you for many, many days, no matter how many times you wash yourself.
Oh boy, I hope I never get sprayed by that horrible, disgusting smell.
horrible smell is a very effective defense technique that a skunk has. Many foxes and wolves will not even try to attack a skunk because they are afraid of that terrible smell.
Oh, I'm afraid of that terrible smell. I've smelled it before, sometimes driving in the car. All right, well, here's our skunk pictures. And we might need some tape.
Here.
Remember we had some tape before?
Yep.
Let's do some tape because the wind's blowing a little bit here. But that's okay. It's a beautiful day, right, Jack?
Yes, I like it.
Okay. Oops. Got stuck on my finger. All right, pretty easy. Oh, I forgot to show everybody. There's a famous skunk right here. I had a sticker. Pepe the Pew. Did you ever watch the Pepe the Pew cartoons? Did you, Jack?
I have not.
I did. He's French. All right, pretty easy. We are gonna start right here where I say begin. And then our skunk is facing towards Jack. So all the way up here. And I'm just gonna make a shape like that. Doesn't have to be perfect. We'll fix it up. Okay, and I have a skunk holding a flower over here. Let's give our skunk an ear here, and we'll do another one here, and we'll erase this. Okay, I'm gonna give my skunk a pretty big nose. I'm gonna color it in. Oh, what color are skunks?
Black and white.
Black and white. Okay, my skunk is gonna smile, and I am gonna put two eyes, eyelids. Remember, this is your creation. You can make your skunk purple if you want, right? And I'm gonna go like that. Okay, now remember how we did the squirrel. All we did right here, we just made a big circle, and then we went 1, 2, 3, and I brought it here. Okay, mine's going a little diagonal. I'll fix that up though. And I'm gonna erase this line here with this eraser. You would use your pencil eraser, right? Let's straighten it out a little bit. There, I like that better, do you?
Looks good.
Okay. And we'll erase right here. And let's erase up here a little bit so we don't see that, okay? And then the other leg is coming out, but we don't see it. So there's 1, 2, 3 feet right there, toes rather. All right, let's put our skunk's tail on, ready? And we're gonna go up, just sort of like we did the squirrel. But this time, we're gonna put all these lines in it. Okay, 1, 2, we'll do that. Okay, now our skunk is holding a flower. Okay, so that's bring an arm down here, and then we will put 1, 2, I'll put one here like that, and then I'm going to erase this right here, and we'll make a little flower. Flowers are so easy. Look, circle, and look, there's our wave mark again. Okay. Now, what else do we need? Our skunk has a black stripe and white stripes. So, oh, our skunk, I like to do this. This would be white.
What if a dog would encounter a skunk? Have you ever smelled a dog?
Oh, my goodness. That would be terrible. Right here, I'm going to just sort of scribble and go like diagonal, like that. And then I'm gonna do over here is go like this. Spike it out. just spike out right here. And this is the mark I'm using. Looks like a scribble. And then I'm going to do it here as well and go down. And then I will erase right here this line. Erase that line. Here comes the wind again.
You ever see one of these skunks?
Yes, I've seen a skunk.
But don't you usually smell them for miles before you normally see them?
Yes. Yeah, me too. Yeah, it doesn't smell too good, huh?
Yeah.
All right, let's fix up this foot here. Fix that one up. Okay, now the tail. Let's spike the tail out. We're just going to go like that to spike it out. That same mark right there. And it's all about the details. And you really don't even have to spike it out if you don't want to. But I like to spike it out. I love to give the details. Okay, we'll go like that. Now, I can't color too good on my wipe-off board. But you could color your skunk in black. I would suggest, if you're doing a skunk, maybe to use some black crayon. Because if you use some markers, guess what? You're going to lose the lines right here, like that line and that line. Okay, and let's do right here, black. I'm just going to go real fast because Jack said we're running out of time. Okay.
Sorry.
And that's it for our skunk. And our skunk could be in a bunch of flowers right here. Smelling the flowers. Look at this skunk right here. He's holding his nose. Because there's all these smelly socks right here. This also is a drawing mark right here. I made it green. That means everything right here stinks, right? Like that joke you told.
He got his nerve holding his nose because he smells socks.
Yeah, he smells the dirty socks. And they're very smelly. Now this one, he's smelling all the flowers. And you could do black or white or whatever color you want. And like I said, if you're using markers, I would maybe use a black colored pencil or a crayon. Because you don't want to lose all your lines right there. All right, everybody, that's it for today. I hope you had fun. Don't forget, if you want to send any of your drawings in to the Facebook page of the Bethel Park Recreation Center and the Bethel Park Community Center, we'll show them. We want to see your drawings. We hope you're having a great day, and we hope you keep on drawing. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.
Next time.
Bye.